War in Afghanistan, 2001-2018, Stability Problems. In a 2008 interview, the then-head U.S. Central Command General David H. Petraeus insisted that the Taliban were gaining strength. He cited a recent increase in attacks in Afghanistan and in neighboring Pakistan. Petraeus insisted that the problems in Afghanistan were more complicated than the ones he had faced in Iraq during his tour and required removing widespread sanctuaries and strongholds. Observers have argued that the mission in Afghanistan is hampered by a lack of agreement on objectives, a lack of resources, lack of coordination, too much focus on the central government at the expense of local and provincial governments, and too much focus on the country instead of the region. In 2009, Afghanistan moved 3 places in Transparency International's annual index of corruption, becoming the world's second most corrupt country just ahead of Somalia. In the same month, Maulana Joya, a former member of the Afghan parliament and the author of Raising My Voice, expressed opposition to an expansion of the U.S. military presence and her concerns about the future. 8 years ago, the U.S. and NATO, under the banner of women's rights, human rights, and democracy, occupied my country and pushed us from the frying pan into the fire. 8 years is enough to know better about the corrupt, mafia system of President Hamid Karzai. My people are crushed between two powerful enemies. From the sky, occupation forces bomb and kill civilians, and on the ground, the Taliban and warlords continue their crimes. It is better that they leave my country, my people are that fed up. Occupation will never bring liberation, and it is impossible to bring democracy by war. Pakistan plays a central role in the conflict. A 2010 report published by the London School of Economics says that Pakistan's IC has an official policy of support to the Taliban. Pakistan appears to be playing a double game of astonishing magnitude, the report states. Amrullah Saleh, former director of Afghanistan's intelligence service, stated, "We talk about all these proxies, Taliban, Haqqanis, but not the master of proxies, which is the Pakistan Army. The question is, what does Pakistan's army want to achieve? They want to gain influence in the region about the presence of foreign troops in Afghanistan," he stated. "They fight for the U.S. national interest, but without them we will face massacre and disaster and God knows what type of a future Afghanistan will have."